He knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
It looks like Lisa is at it again. She doesn't like her new apartment, so she's asking you to help her move one more time. This time, there are only two boxes, but you don't feel like moving them one at a time, so you tie some ropes around them in order to pull them across the floor simultaneously. The smaller box is 5 kilograms, and it's connected to the larger 12 kilogram box by rope A. You pull the larger box using rope B, and you pull with a force of 30 newtons. If the coefficient of friction between the boxes and the floor is 0.081, what is the acceleration of the boxes, and what is the tension in rope A? In this problem, we need Newton's laws, and we need to know a bit about friction and tension. So if you haven't seen my tutorials on these subjects, check those out now. When you're ready, give it a shot. The first thing we want to do is find the acceleration of the boxes. To do this, we can treat them as one system. Combining the masses of the boxes, we have a mass of 17 kilograms. That gives us a gravitational force of 167 newtons, which will also be the normal force. Then, to get the force of friction, we multiply the coefficient of friction by the normal force, and that gives us 13.5 newtons. We also have the applied force of 30 newtons. To get the net force, we see that the vertical forces cancel out, so we just take the 30 newtons in the positive direction, subtract the 13.5 newtons in the negative direction, and we get 16.5 newtons as the net force in the positive direction. Now it's just F equals ma. We have 16.5 newtons, the 17 kilogram combined mass, and we solve for acceleration, which will be 0.971 meters per second squared. Now for the trickier part. If we want to find the tension in rope A, we can't look at the whole system. We have to focus on the forces acting on the smaller box. So let's make a free body diagram for that one by itself. Now, the gravitational force on this box is 5 kilograms times 9.8 for G, which is 49 newtons. That will also be the normal force, as there is no vertical motion. The frictional force is therefore the frictional coefficient times the normal force, which gives us 3.97 newtons in the negative direction. Then, in the forward direction, there is the tension of rope A. Now here's the clever part. We know the mass of the box, and we know the acceleration of the box, as both boxes are accelerating in the same way. So we should be able to find the net force acting on the smaller box. That's 5 kilograms times 0.971 meters per second squared, or 4.86 newtons. But this net force is the sum of the frictional force and the tension of rope A, so we can say that friction plus tension equals net force. Plugging in our values, making sure to keep the frictional force negative, since it points in the negative direction, we see that we have to add this value to both sides, and we get 8.83 newtons for the tension of rope A. This makes sense, as the friction must be detracting from the tension to produce a smaller net force. As to whether this whole fiasco with ropes was worth the trouble is anyone's guess. All we know is that the moving is almost over, so it's about time for another round of post-move snacks. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.